इंडियन कोस्ट लाइन। इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक बाय विच वी कैन इफेक्टिवली अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ इंडियन मॉनसून। स्पेसिफिकली यू कैन से इट्स समर मॉनसून और साउथ वेस्टर्न मॉनसून, बिकॉज दिस टू थिंग्स दैट मीन्स इंडियन कोस्ट लाइन एंड इंडियन मॉनसून आर इंटर रिलेटेड विद इच अदर। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ कोस्ट और वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस कोस्ट, स्टेट्स एंड यूनियन टेरिटोरीज अंडर इंडियन कोस्टल प्लेन, its divisions on the basis of its direction and the subdivisions of western coastal plain. Okay, so welcome to geography in short with the special topic Indian coastline. Coast simply means the area or region which is very near to the sea surface and ocean surface. In India, the area in between Arabian Sea and Western Ghats is the western coast, whereas the area in between Bay of Bengal and Eastern Ghats is the eastern coastal plain. So here in this map, all of you can see in the western part we are having Arabian Sea and here we are having Western Ghats. Now this white shaded region in between this Western Ghats and Arabian Sea is simply known as Western Coastal Plain. Okay, in the same way, along the eastern half of our Indian subcontinent we are having Bay of Bengal and here we are having Eastern Ghats. In the same way, this region or this white shaded region in between this Eastern Ghats and Bay of Bengal is simply known as Eastern Coastal Plain. So if we subdivide our whole Indian coastal plain on the basis of its direction, then we will simply get our two subdivisions. Along the western side, we are having Western Coast in between Arabian Sea and Western Ghats, and along the eastern coast, we are having our Eastern Coastal Plain in between Bay of Bengal and Eastern Ghats. Clear? Now we will discuss about the states under this Indian coastal plain. Under states we are having Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and West Bengal. In this map, here we are having Gujarat, then Maharashtra, this little one is Goa, after that we are having Karnataka, then Kerala here, this one is Tamil Nadu, then Andhra Pradesh. The northern part of this Andhra Pradesh is simply known as Telangana, after that Odisha, and last one is West Bengal. So under Indian coastal plain we are having total 9 states. Okay, with the states we are having two important union territories also under this Indian coastal plain. These are Daman Diu and Pondicherry. Here in this part we are having Diu, here we are having Daman, and in this part of Tamil Nadu we are having parts of Pondicherry. Okay, so under Indian coastal plain we are having total 9 states and 2 union territories. Next we will discuss about the division of western coastal plain. The first one is Konkan coast. The coast from Daman to Goa is simply known as Konkan coast or Maharashtra and Goa coast. This is the northern part of this plain. So just look at this map. Here all of you can see this is the location of Daman. Here we are having Goa region. Now the entire region from Daman to Goa is simply known as Konkan coast. Now this Konkan coast mainly covers the states of Maharashtra and Goa. Here all of you can see this one. That's why this Konkan coast is also known as Maharashtra and Goa coast. Now if we subdivide our western coastal plain from north to south, then this Konkan coast is the northern part of this plain. Okay, next one is the Kannada coast. The coast of Karnataka is Kannada or Karavali coast. It is the central part of this plain. Now after Goa, here we are having Karnataka region. Now after Goa, this Karnataka region except some parts of southern Karnataka, we are having this as Kannada coast. Okay, now this Kannada coast mainly covers parts of Karnataka. That's why this coast is simply known as Karnataka coast or Karavali coast. After Konkan coast, this is the central part of this western coastal plain. Perfect. The last subdivision we are having Malabar coast. The southern part is the Malabar coast or Kerala and Karnataka coast, mainly covers northern parts of Kerala state. Okay, so here All of you can see, after Karnataka state, we are having Kerala region. Now, after Karnataka, mainly southern part of Karnataka and northern part of Kerala comes under this Malabar coastal region or Malabar coastal plain. Okay, this region mainly cover parts of southern Karnataka and northern Kerala. That's why this is also known as Kerala and Karnataka coast. This is the southern part of western coastal plain. Okay, some geographers describes the entire region from Konkan coast to the tip of the subcontinent at Kanyakumari, Tamil Nadu as Malabar coast. What is the meaning of that? According to some geographers, there are only two subdivisions of western coastal plain. The first one, or the northern one, is simply known as Konkan coast, which is from Daman to Goa, and the southern part of this western coastal plain we are having as Malabar coast. After Goa, the entire region up to this Kanyakumari Tamil Nadu region, this entire region comes under Malabar coast. So the northern half of this western coastal plain is Konkan and southern half is Malabar. Okay, but according to most geographers, there are three subdivisions. The northern part is Konkan, the central part is Kannada, and the southern part is Malabar coast. Okay, Konkan mainly covers the states of Maharashtra and Goa. Kannada mainly covers the states of Karnataka region. Malabar mainly covers southern parts of Karnataka and northern parts of Kerala. The next part we will continue in our next video. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching.